When you look at the schedule, and as you said, Paul, you got this team that's right behind you three more times over the next 12 games. So it's a huge game for both teams. I think it's going to set the tone of how this series is going to go, this little mini series of three games. And it's going to happen here at Amalie.
Don Sweeney putting this group together. Stamkos after it. Here comes the hit from Miller. And the Bruins look to re-enter. And here's a shot saved by Andre Vasilevsky there on David Krejci, the veteran centerman.
And then the Boston Bruins catch everybody standing still. So on the attack, they get their first good scoring chance. Vasilevsky in good position to make the save, though.
And Tommy Wingles is stepped into there by Callahan. Krug is open. He's got a man in front. They score. Pasternak cutting by the net.
And Torrey Krug is a terrific quarterback. back on the point for the Boston Bruins. Whether it's 5-on-5 or on the power play, this is a great shot pass. You see the momentum that Pasternak had? He just blew through about three different Lightning players. Nobody had him. You have to pick him up, pick that speed up, recognize the speed early on. Torrey Krug recognized it, and all he had to do was put the puck on the stick.
And a 4-2 Edmonton win this afternoon over the Panthers at 3 points. So he's up there at 89 points as well, and we'll see him tomorrow. Here's Heine with a backhander and a save by Vasilevsky.
Lightning a little slow to react from their blue line in. They've already given up a goal because of that, sorting things out and letting people leak through or filter through. This time it's Heine, and he is on his backhand, which is a good thing. You have to force him to the outside. If there's a mistake and somebody gets through like that, then Riley Nash had a lot of miles on him so far, especially with the injuries. Backes has been hurt early on in the year, was suspended, so they want to give him a chance.
Point shooting, a save by Rask. The first shot comes at the 9:01 mark for the Lightning.
I think last game against Ottawa was one of the very few games where Brayden Point's line never really got going. It just never really established much, didn't have many offensive chances. So I figured they'd probably come out really busting, and they certainly have.
And Stamber 51 minutes on the season to lead the Lightning. Toyota power play chance goes to the Bruins, and here's Krug firing, and he fires it wide out in front. Save Vasilevsky, they score! He got a piece of the shot out in front, but it dropped behind him.
Puck possession, there's Krug, top of the screen. Now watch the Bruins go to the front of the net. After the puck comes off the end wall, the play is actually made by Rick Nash. See how slick he was to lift Miller's stick after the shot goes off the end wall? Watch this right here. Miller wants to play it. A little bit of the lift of the stick. David Backes was moving in. He's in perfect position. Nobody has him.
Trying to get it in front. Was slowed down by Girardi. Point. Trying to get that puck to center. Grizzlick held it in. Grizzlick walks in. There's the shot by Pasternak. It stopped. Set it in front. And Vasilevsky diving across. And his teammates make sure he can cover that puck and get a whistle with Backes right there.
And you can see the Lightning coming back. It disorients you. When you make a mistake like this and you know it should get out of the zone, then you come back to a spot, it seems like everybody freezes up a little bit. That's what happened to the Lightning in this last shift, and they're fortunate that one didn't end up in the back of the net. The Bruins defense, Miller in particular, was out hunting that entire period, and I think it caught more than a couple of guys looking backwards.
Here's Point in front, shooting Rask, the save as Yanni Gord found him.
The Brayden Point line started the second period just like they started the first, and it was Yanni Gord getting in on the play and another really good scoring chance for Brayden Point. He tries to go higher up in the net this time than he did in the first period, but doesn't quite get it up high enough under the bar. Tuukka Rask comes out.
Strawman comes over for the Lightning. Long pass to Stamkos. Steps in with Miller and Kucherov. Kucherov with it, fires, and that was deflected.
Crossbar, it sounded like. While the Lightning are attacking in the zone, a little 2-on-1 between Stamkos and Kucherov working Torrey Krug, and a nice shot by Nikita Kucherov. Deflected, I think, maybe off a stick, but it goes clank right off the joint of the crossbar and the post. Meanwhile, Miller trying to go to the front of the net gets tripped up by Carlo, and there's your penalty.
A pass out for Ernie as the penalties expire. Ernie around the Bruin defense. Girardi back in behind to Ernie. Here comes McDonough. He fires, and it's snared by Rask. Well, you can see McDonough activate as soon as Ernie got the puck.
And then there's a McDonough chance moving in from the point.
And the Lightning on the kill have given up goals in 11 of 12 games. Pasternak playing it back. Now Krug sending it on goal, saved by Vasilevsky. They score. Riley Nash punched it home on the rebound.
Get pucks to the net and then rebound. Last time it came off the end wall and came right into the scoring area. This time the rebound comes out. There's a battle. And Boston gets to the puck first. Shot, everything Torrey Krug touches turns to gold. Riley Nash comes in from the deep slot, is able to fish it out from in between the feet of Girardi. Girardi's in a good battle against Nash. It's not Girardi's fault, but somebody's got to get in. The secondary help for Girardi. Smart stick by Marchand. He knows where Hedman wants to go. He can tell by his body language he wants to give it to Kucherov.
Lead pass to Kucherov. He speeds in. Now to Stamkos shooting. Rask got over with a stop. And it's fired out to the point.
Steven Stamkos had a couple looks at the net. Nikita Kucherov, who was always looking for him, beautiful seam pass, a really difficult one-timer to get away. But nobody better in the game than Stamkos. They used the open ice that was there on an indirect pass in order to get the puck deep and create some speed and a chance.
Marchand has a man open, cutting through Pasternak, sends it out in front. It's taken away by Dodgson.
Right here in the neutral zone, this is one of those really difficult situations for Jake Dodgson. You're the defender, and it's a bouncing puck. He tried to do the right thing and try to get in front of Marchand. He realized it was a bouncing puck, but he's adapted really well and gotten better and better as the game gone on.
Ernie with a big collision on Corrali down low, and the Lightning end up with possession. That shot deflects through, backhanded wide by Killorn. He had the open side and backhanded it under Rask and wide of the post.
Yeah, it's one of those things. The puck comes out to you, you're on your backhand, you get one whack at it, you get it away as quickly as possible.
McDonough fires, and it's blocked in traffic in the slot. Paquette kept the play alive, back to McDonough. Kunitz. Marquette shooting, it's off McQuaid, and diving out to hold play was Rask.
There is not much room, but you got to fight for every inch, and you got to hope you get a bounce. The Boston Bruins have been able to do that. Both of their power play goals were battles in front of the net. They got to a loose puck first.
He's where everything starts for this Boston power play. Marchand circling. Krizna back to Krug firing, and he fires that one over the net. It deflects off the glass and out of play.
Boston has changed around their power play a little bit. Krug is always back there on the point. Brad Marchand, who was a net front guy or down low off to the edge, has moved over into the half wall.
Olachary will lift it out and down the ice, and Schaller trying to beat the icing, and they rule that he did. And he'll tie up the Lightning here for the final seconds. That'll do it here at Amalie Arena, as the Boston Bruins win this one, and a shutout for Tuukka Rask, 3-0. And for Rask, it is his 41st career shutout, fifth time he shut out the Lightning.